Good evening, MEA viewers, and welcome to another episode of our Spotlight program. Today I have with me Katrina Studevant. She is the director for the Karmanos Cancer Institute and also the race chair for the Susan G. Komen Detroit Race for the Cure. I am also joined by Hiam Hamadi. She is the Chronic Disease Prevention Program Supervisor at ACCESS, which is a Middle Eastern organization that we're very familiar with. Ththank you both so much for joining us, ladies.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much. Katrina, I know we did have our interview last week, but breast cancer, like we talked about, is not just a one-day race thing. We want to know a little bit more. Just refresh our viewers on exactly what Karmanos does and what they do for the Race for the Cure.
Karmanos Cancer Institute has been the local presenting sponsor for the Susan G. Komen Detroit Race for the Cure since inception.
Yes.
The race started in 1992, and it was started by a doctor at the Karmanos Cancer Institute that thought it would be a good idea to host this event. What they thought would get a few hundred people out yielded hundreds, thousands at that time. So we're gearing up for the May 16th race happening at Shane Park in downtown Detroit.
Great. And Shane Park is the new location.
We want to make sure
everyone knows it's the new location.
Yes, it's right along the Detroit Riverfront. Really beautiful venue.
Yes, beautiful. So, Hiam, can you tell us what ACCESS does for the Race for the Cure as well?
Well, if I want to speak about ACCESS first,
yes.
That ACCESS is a comprehensive primary healthcare organization dedicated to the provision of holistic and humanistic health services to all communities residing in southeastern Michigan.
Mm-hmm.
So ACCESS has been providing services for over 42 years now.
Wow.
And then he offers all types of services, and then one of those, you know, our program, which is the cancer program, it's the breast cancer outreach program.
Yes.
So it is in collaboration with the Komen Detroit Race for the Cure.
Okay, great. And you got that through the grant that was offered from Karmanos Cancer Institute, correct?
Yes, we do.
Okay, and can you tell us a little bit about that grant and how the money is used to and put back into the community?
Well, as I said, you know, this program and then this funds is to improve access to the free breast cancer screening.
Yes.
Because as you know, there is many barriers to cancer in our community. So for example, like lack of knowledge, health beliefs, language barrier, you know, transportation, and et cetera, with many. So our goal is to work on those barriers through outreach educational program.
Yes.
So thanks to Detroit Race for the Cure, whom were able to fund us through funds raised through the walk, the one they do, especially the one in May.
Mm-hmm.
So with those dollars, it helps us to reach out to our community.
Yes.
So how we use this money, the breast cancer outreach program at ACCESS, as I said, it is funded by Detroit Race for the Cure. It provides community-based, in-home, bilingual, and culturally sensitive breast cancer education.
Yes.
So also we provide screening service. So our goal is to reach 2,000 women and to screen like 1,500 women.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
So, yeah, so the money is used, like, you know, we provide seminars, presentations, as I said, also home visit. We visit the women in their homes to give them the education so they learn about risk factors.
Yes.
So they come for screening.
That's great. Actually, I've actually been to one of those screening seminars that have been held by ACCESS. So many women attend because A, they don't have the money, or B, they don't have the time. They can bring their children with them. It's usually on a weekend. It's very convenient. And I like that you guys go to people's homes because there are a lot of people that are not able to make it to the centers where ACCESS provides their services. So you guys truly extend your services to the community.
Thank you.
And we're very grateful for it.
Yeah, and then especially those, you know, presentations, it's on a weekly basis. We do it every Wednesday and every Fridays, you know, at our center in Dearborn.
Okay.
And then we do it every Thursdays in our center in Macomb.
Okay. Okay, yeah. That's wonderful.
Thank you.
So ladies, how did we come together? How did Karmanos and ACCESS start to work together? And how do you work together to get as much as you can out of the Race for the Cure?
Oh, that's a great question. So Komen, locally, puts out a request for grant applications.
Okay.
And Access, of course, met the needs that we were looking for as far as criteria and priorities for our area. Every year, courtesy of the race, we're able to grant out dollars. So that means the registration dollars, the dollars from our sponsors, and the fundraising dollars go into a total pot. So then that way we were able to grant dollars to the local breast cancer programs in our service areas, which are Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb counties. And then we're also able to donate to research, national level research.
Yes.
So Access was one of the grantees for 2014. And that was part of our grant back into the community of nearly $900,000.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah.
That's so great. It's nice to because I'm obviously part of the community, I go to all the events, just so nice to see all these organizations working together. And for our community to get that monetary support, because as Hiam said, we don't always have that, and especially in certain areas.
Right.
So that's wonderful.
The need is great in Detroit.
It is.
And in that surrounding area, Wayne, Oakland, Macomb counties. What we found, because currently we're doing a community assessment, and we're finding that the needs as far as Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb exceed the needs of the United States average.
Wow.
As far as incident rates, as far as late stage diagnosis, as well as mortality, Michigan has higher rates in all areas than the United States average.
Wow, that's amazing.
So there's a lot of work to be done.
Yes, there is. But we're getting on it, right?
Yes, we're on it.
Yeah. And then, you know, as I said before, we offer services also in Macomb and then in Wayne County. The thing that, you know, our community, you have lots of refugees and newcomers to Oakland and Macomb.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, thanks to Detroit Race for the Cure and then for the people who donated and then who participated in this race. Why? Because, you know, the need is really tremendous there.
Yeah.
We need it so bad, you know, with the newcomers. They don't know anything about cancer or their risk factor or what to do. So it's really needed there.
Yeah, I agree. Well, now that we know the statistics, we can get more information out there. And the race really helps. Access and Carmanos work very, very hard for this. So this year, I know we talked about it last time in our interview, but I would like you to reiterate what we're expecting this year and just tell our viewers how we can meet that goal. I know there's not a monetary goal, but we want to obviously do as much as we can.
Well, we set goals. We set high expectations.
Yeah.
Every possible person, every possible dollar to make the biggest impact. That's our goals every year. And we try to meet, if not exceed, those goals. This year, they can expect the same traditions as in the past.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have bands along our East Jefferson route. We'll have a survivor trolley for those survivors that may be having some difficulty with walking the route.
Yes.
We'll also have our survivor cafe and pink carpet where they'll have an opportunity to dance and celebrate.
That's so nice.
Have a memorial site where, you know, we'll recognize the lives that have been lost to this disease and a host of other exciting, cool new surprises.
Wow.
So May 16th is really going to be one of the best days in the city of Detroit, we believe.
The massive pink.
It is.
It's my favorite time of the year. I love seeing those pictures.
Yes.
Okay, so ladies, let's just give some information on how to get in touch with both organizations and your message to the community. We'll start with you, Katrina.
Sure. Most people want to know how to make an impact, and it's simple. Register. Register for the event. You can register online at carmanuscancer.org/ComeInDetroit, or you can call 1-800-CARMANUS, but registration is key. It supports the dollars that will go towards the funding of local breast cancer programs for education, for screening, as well as treatment.
Great, thank you. And we'll also put the information for the Carmanos website and the number on the screen. So just pay attention to that. Pay attention to that, and we'll also put the information for Access.
Yes. And then, you know, my message is to our community. With my experience, for 20 years, I'm working with cancer programs, then I know how many cases we do have.
Yes.
Unfortunately, most of those cases, you know, they are in late stage because it's not discovered early, because then we know that the key to treat cancer is to early detection.
Yes.
And in our community, they don't know that. So my advice is to start early, to come for screening, and to participate in the race. Please, you can call me if you don't know how to go online and to register. If they call me, and then I will help them. And then really, we need to see them there. Yes. Because, you know, every dollar, it counts. And since most of this money, it comes to the community. So it comes back to you. Mm-hmm. So we need to do the education. We need to do the screening. We need to save lives.
Yes.
So please, we do that. We need to conquer cancer.
Yes, we do.
Yes.
That's a great, great message.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ladies, for all of the information. We will list all of the resources so that you can get your screenings for your early detection and be a part of the race for the cure. Thank you for joining us, and we will see you next time on the next episode of Spotlight. Good night.